Berkeley Botanical Garden, and later I'm meeting my friend and giving her these t-shirts that I made for her, and this is the statement that she wanted on it: animals are people. And here's my funny story. Actually, it's a good message, right? Animals are people. It means that you believe in animal rights, because animals are essentially non-human people. When you would give them those rights to not be seen as property or commodities anymore. So I posted this, a picture of the shirt and me, in a vegans page, Vegans of the Bay actually, and I got a lot of likes, so thank you for that. And I found four or five vegans that did not understand the message. So in a vegan group, I posted this in a vegan group, and they questioned the message. They said that it did not make sense to them. Some of them were just confused. I think somebody said that doesn't make logical sense. I mean, because people are people, but animals aren't people, so how does that make sense? Animals aren't people. And I don't understand their point of view either. There was a vegan who backed me up with the animals are people stance. It is what vegans believe. And there was an article of this news that was a year ago, where India gave cetaceans, sea animals, dolphins, whales, not the recognition of rights. So they have non-human rights, animal rights. They're not in aquariums or being used and exploited for entertainment. Don't go to SeaWorld, right? So boycotting that kind of animal abuse, banning it, because they're giving the dolphins rights like humans, because, you know, animals are people, they have personalities, they have feelings, they feel pain, they feel joy, and they should just be considered like us in the ways that truly matter, right? So I also want to say happy fall. It is officially past the autumnal equinox, and I am actually taking a break from school, and I'm out here at the UC Berkeley Botanical Garden. Visit your local parks and your local libraries. It's always refreshing and gives me a sense of peace. And I'm just happy to be out here in nature, you know, just being in nature and looking at plants, being in the green, seeing some wildlife. And fun fact, when I was little, I used to visit the San Francisco Botanical Garden, and that's in Golden Gate Park, and it's really great there. It's even bigger. It's one of the biggest gardens I've been to, I suppose. I used to think that how you said botanical was botanical with an N before the T, so it was funny. I thought it was botanical, and then I learned that botany meant the study of plants, so there we go, botanical garden. I guess it's not really like natural either too, because they plant these things and they have labels on them, so it's purposeful and it's not just entirely native, though there are some California native plants.
Something new.
just walking through the sprinklers like a rebel, and there's that beautiful rainbow. And yes, it is wet below and on top. It's worth it though for this view. Isn't that so cool?
Baklava, it just comes on the side if you like. Delicious.
Oh, okay. You know what? I will have a pocket and drink.
A pocket and a drink. Okay, like so it? The combo number two.
No tomato, please. Thank you. I think so.
Now, I want your little girls to pay attention.
Okay, you ready? He's gonna throw some.
I'm gonna show you where we're close flying gloves.